Under part 1, we are going to discuss about single phase fully controlled rectifier fed separately excited DC motor drive for continuous conduction mode. To watch the previous videos, the link is given in the description box. If you feel like any doubts in this video lectures, you can comment in the comment box and I will reply to the comments. So now let us move on to the today's session. So here this circuit consists of T1, T2, T3, T4, 4 number of thyristors with a single phase supply supplied here with the value of Vs. This is called as single phase fully controlled rectifier. A rectifier with thyristors T1, T2, T3 and T4 with a single phase supply here Vs is a rectifier module, and the power from this rectifier is fed to this motor drive. Okay. So now our aim is to control the speed of this motor drive using this rectifier module. So now let us see how it can be done. Here IA represents the armature current of the motor, RA represents the armature resistance of the motor, LA represents the armature inductance of the motor, and here this E represents the induced EMF of the motor, A and AA. These two represents the armature terminals of the motor, and here VA represents the armature voltage of the motor. Now let us discuss the operation of this single phase fully controlled rectifier fed with a separately excited DC motor. So for this, here let me have the waveform. So this waveform represents the single phase AC supply, okay, with the magnitude of VS. This is our single phase AC supply input voltage. So now let me take a firing angle of alpha, okay, firing angle of alpha less than 90 degree, firing angle alpha less than 90 degree, and the range of this firing angle lies between 0 degrees to 90 degrees, that means less than 90 degrees, 0 to 90 degrees. So this is our 90 degrees, right? This is our 90 degrees instant, so less than 90 degrees, somewhere here I am choosing, and this also consists of the induced EMF E line also, which I didn't draw. See here, now I'm drawing it. The induced EMF which is present for this DC motor should also be drawn here. So I have drawn this, and I am choosing this firing angle alpha somewhere alpha less than 90 degree here. So I'm choosing this point. This is our 90 degrees, and less than 90 degrees I am choosing here alpha, and this point is pi, and this is pi plus alpha, and this is 2 pi, and here this is 2 pi plus alpha. Okay. So now let us see the triggering points of the thyristors, or the triggering instants of the thyristors. So at this angle alpha, this thyristor T1 and T4 starts its conduction. Thyristors T1 and T4 starts its conduction at an angle of pi plus alpha at this instant. Okay, at an angle of pi plus alpha at this instance, thyristors T2 and T3. Okay, thyristors T2 and T3 starts its conduction. Again, at an instant of 2 pi plus alpha at this instant. Okay, at this instant again the old thyristors T1 and T4 comes into the conduction. Okay, so these are the triggering instants, or the triggering angles, or the triggering points of the thyristors. So let us extend these lines for this armature current also. So now let us draw the output voltage VA, which is nothing but the armature voltage for this DC motor drive, and armature current for this DC motor drive. Okay, so for that let us draw the equivalent circuit. So first, during positive half cycle, okay, during positive half cycle, what happens is the current starts from the phase terminal and it passes through the thyristor T1. Okay, our armature current IA starts from the terminal phase P and travels through the thyristor T1, and it passes through the armature terminal A, that means enters towards the armature terminal A and leaves from the armature terminal AA and it enters into the thyristor T4 and completes its journey at the neutral terminal. So our armature current is traveling from phase to the thyristor T1 and enters into the terminal A and leaves from the terminal AA and enters into the thyristor T4 and completes its journey at the neutral point N. So this is our the current flowing path during positive half cycle, and here this value of the voltage is Vs. As we mentioned here, the value of the voltage is Vs and the voltage across this is Va, across the armature terminals is Va, right? So this is our Va. Okay, so if we look at this equivalent circuit, it is known that Va is equal to Vs, right? Here Va and here Vs. So if you apply KVL to this loop, okay, if you apply KVL to this loop, we will get Va is equal to Vs. Therefore, our output voltage Va here should be equal to the supply voltage Vs. That means this is our supply voltage Vs during the positive half cycle. That means from alpha to pi plus alpha is our positive half cycle. Okay, from alpha to pi plus alpha is our positive half cycle. So during that time, our output voltage Va should be equal to the supply voltage Vs. So let us draw that. So this is our alpha. I mean, it should follow as exactly as like this, because our armature output voltage is equal to supply voltage Vs. Okay, our armature output voltage is equal to the supply voltage Vs during the positive half cycle. That means from alpha to pi plus alpha. Therefore, it should be like this. So let us draw this trace here like this. Okay, so this is our during positive half cycle by the thyristors T1 and T4. So now let us discuss about the negative half cycle. That means at this instant, negative half cycle, that means from pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha up to here. Okay, pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha. So during negative half cycle, that means from pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha. Okay, so which are the two thyristors now come into the conduction? Nothing but T2 and T3. Okay, so now let us draw the equivalent circuit for this. So at this condition, our armature current starts from the neutral point. Our armature current starts from the neutral point and it moves towards the thyristor T3. Okay, and it comes into the terminal, armature terminal A, and leaves through the armature terminal AA. Here it is IA, which is entering into the A and leaving through the AA, and it completes its journey through thyristor T2 at the phase terminal. So our armature current is starting its journey from the neutral terminal and it is flowing through the thyristor T3 and entering into A and leaving through AA, and it is passing through T2 and completing its journey at phase. So this is our current path during the negative half cycle when our instants are pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha. So if you look at this equivalent circuit, now the supply is reversed. See, here it is phase and neutral. So at that time our supply voltage is plus Vs. Now here it is, if you look at this equivalent circuit, this has reversed neutral and phase. Therefore now the supply voltage is minus Vs and here is our output voltage, okay, Va. So at this instant, I mean during the negative half cycle, our Va is equal to if you apply KVL to this loop, you will get Va is equal to minus Vs, because here it is minus Vs. Okay, therefore our armature output voltage Va is equal to negative of the input voltage. Okay, so now let us draw this. See here, that means from pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha, that means from this point to this point, that is from this point to this point, okay, from here to here. So now we have to reverse the input voltage in order to get the output voltage. See here, because our armature output voltage during negative half cycle is negative of the input voltage. So if your input voltage is of positive, your output voltage should be negative. If your input voltage is of negative, your output voltage should be positive. That is the meaning of this equation. Okay. See, I am repeating once again. If your input voltage is positive, your output voltage should be negative. Otherwise, if your input voltage is negative, your output voltage should be positive. Because here, armature output voltage is equal to negative of the supply input voltage. So now let us see what is our case. Here, input voltage is negative. Okay. That means our output voltage should be positive. Okay. Here, this is our negative input voltage. Therefore, our output voltage should be positive because here it is negative of the input voltage. Whatever the input voltage is there, it has to be reversed. Therefore, now your output voltage will be like this. So, it is following this curve. Okay, from here to here, like this. From here to here, that is negativized. That means this has to be reversed because here whatever the input voltage we are giving, it has to be reversed. So through this equation, okay, therefore it is reversed. So since it is negative, it has made positive. Therefore, if you look at this waveform, we are able to get the positive output voltage. See, here also it is positive and here also it is positive. So what is a DC voltage? Basically, see, a DC voltage is nothing but a unidirectional waveform, only the positive cycle. See, here also it has only the positive. Okay, so here it is a, but this is a pulsated DC output voltage. Okay, so now let us draw the current waveforms. So during the instant here, during the positive half cycle, from alpha to pi plus alpha, the current is passing through the thyristors T1 and T4, right? So the current is passing through the T1 and T4 from alpha to pi plus alpha. Okay. So therefore, and at pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha, that means during negative half cycle, at the instance pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha, our thyristors T2 and T3 continues its conduction. Therefore, now the current is passing through the thyristors T2 and T3 from pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha. Here it is 2 pi plus alpha. Thyristors T2, T3. So, if you observe at this current waveform, never it is becoming zero, because from alpha to pi plus alpha during the positive half cycle, our current is passing through the thyristors T1 and T4, and from pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha here, okay, the current is passing through the thyristors T2 and T3. So, the current is always continuous. Hence, it is known as continuous conduction mode. Whenever the current never becomes zero and it is continuously flowing, that is said to be the continuous conduction mode. So, in order to maintain this continuous conduction mode, your torque should be high. That means your load should be high. Okay, when your torque is high, your armature current is also high, because for a DC motor, torque is directly proportional to the armature current. So, if it is the case, your armature inductance, which is present in the motor, will be sufficient, is sufficient enough to supply the power to the to the thyristors to maintain its conduction in a continuous way. Okay, so if our torque is high, our armature current is high, therefore our armature inductance will be high in order to maintain continuous conduction. So as far as the armature inductance value is high, our continuous conduction will be achieved. So based on the value of the armature inductance, we can decide either it is continuous conduction or discontinuous conduction. So now let us analyze this in a quadrant planes. So let us have here VA and here IA. So if you observe at our output voltage, here it is positive, right? so positive. And our armature current is also positive. See here, our armature current is also positive. So both voltage and the current are positive. Therefore, it comes in the first quadrant called forward motoring. Okay, forward motoring. Both voltage and the current are positive. Here voltage is also positive and our current is also positive. Therefore, it comes in the first quadrant called forward motoring. In forward motoring, always the power flows from source to the load. Okay, source to the load, that is called motoring. Okay, in other words, your motor drives the mechanical load. Okay, motor drives the mechanical. So whenever the mechanical load is being driven by a motor, that is said to be motoring load. So for that, your power has to flow from source to the load. So this happens whenever firing angle alpha is less than 90 degrees. Okay, whenever the firing angle alpha is less than 90 degrees, the power flows from source to the load and your motor drives the load, and that is said to be the motoring mode or the forward motoring. Okay, now let us analyze the same controlled rectifier, I mean the single phase fully controlled rectifier, for a DC motor when our firing angle is little bit increased. So now let us assume that the firing angle alpha is greater than 90 degrees. That means the firing angle range lies between 90 degrees to 180 degrees. Okay, the firing angle alpha is 90 degrees to 180 degrees. So here this point is 90 degrees, so greater than, and here, sorry, I have to draw this induced EMF E. Okay, so this is our 90 degrees, so greater than 90 degrees, so here 90 degrees, so greater than 90 degrees, somewhere here I am choosing this as my firing angle alpha, and this is phi, and here we will be getting, this is again the 90 degrees for this negative half cycle, so somewhere here greater than 90 degrees means somewhere here with the same angle. Okay, with the same angle from here to here, from here to here, whatever the angle is maintained, the same will be here also. So this is our pi plus alpha and this is our 2 pi, and here this will be our 2 pi plus alpha. Okay, so now let us first decide which are the thyristors going to conduct at which instance. So at this instant alpha, thyristors T1 and T4 conducts. Okay, that means gets into the triggering point. And at this instant pi plus alpha, our thyristors T2 and T3 comes into the conduction. And again at this instant, this thyristors again will come into the conduction. I mean the next cycle will start. Okay, and so on. So now let us draw the output waveforms for this. So the operation will be the same. Okay, during the negative half, during the positive half cycle, the power, your current flows from here. The same we can take here. During the positive half cycle, the current flows from phase to the thyristor T1, and it flows through the terminal A, and it comes out through the terminal AA, and it flows into the thyristor T4 and completes its journey at the neutral terminal. The same is going to be continued here also, from here to here. Okay, the same is done for this also. So the output voltage is nothing but VA is equal to VS again. Okay, so whatever the input voltage is there, that will be reflected as the output voltage. So now let us draw that. So here this will be the our output voltage. Okay, whatever the input voltage from alpha to pi plus alpha. Okay, now we are trying to draw the output waveform for the positive half cycle from alpha to pi plus alpha. So this will be the our output voltage. Okay, because VA is equal to VS, right? Our output voltage is equal to what? The supply input voltage. So whatever the supply input voltage is here, that should be the output voltage. So here it is drawn as our output voltage. Okay. So now let us analyze during the negative half cycle. That means from pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha. What happens? We will get again like this. Okay. The same is going to happen. Here it is T1, T4. Here it is T2, T3. The same whichever was happened here at this in the previous, the same is going to be happened here. That means our VA is equal to minus VS. So whatever the input voltage is given, that should be the negative. I mean here this is our input voltage, right? This is our input voltage. This should be reversed because here it is minus. So here it is reversed and drawn like this. So this is our negative half cycle. Okay. So now let us draw the current for this. So from alpha to pi, from alpha to pi plus alpha, the current is flowing through T1, T4. From pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha, the current is flowing through the T2 and T3. Therefore, the current never becomes zero and the conduction is continuous conduction. So now let us draw the VA-IA planes for this. So if we look at this, the output voltage is negative here. Okay. Negative here in this firing, when our firing angle alpha is greater than 90 degrees, our output voltage is negative, whereas our current is positive. Therefore, it comes in the fourth quadrant. VA is negative here. Here this is our VA. VA is negative. Okay. Whereas IA is positive. Okay. IA is positive. VA is negative. Therefore, it comes in the fourth quadrant of operation. This is when your firing angle is greater than 90 degrees. That means the firing angle value is ranges between 90 degrees to 180 degrees. Okay, so this fourth quadrant of operation is known as reverse regenerative braking. Okay, reverse regenerative braking. So this means that whenever a single phase fully controlled rectifier is used, we are able to get two quadrants of operation. One is forward motoring and another one is reverse regenerative braking. So what happens is in this reverse regenerative braking is the power flows from load to the source. Okay. The power flows from load to the source. Okay. Whenever our alpha is less than 90 degree, the power flows from source to the load. Whenever the alpha is greater than 90 degrees, that will become the regenerative braking. Therefore, the power flows from load to the source. Okay, so this, now what happens is the kinetic energy or the mechanical energy is fed to the motor and which converts into the electrical energy, and it is fed to the source. Okay, the source supply side. Therefore, now this motor acts as generator, because a generator will accept, I mean the input for the generator is mechanical input energy, which will be converted into the electrical output energy. Therefore, under braking condition, that means whenever our firing angle alpha is greater than 90 degrees, our motor will be trying to act as a generator and the power will flow from load to the source. So this is called as reverse regenerative braking. So when a single phase fully controlled rectifier is used, a DC motor drive can be operated in a two quadrants, such as first quadrant called forward motoring quadrant and in the fourth quadrant called reverse regenerative braking mode. The mathematical analysis for this circuit configuration will be next in the will be discussed in the next session, next part. That means the session 9, part 2. Thank you.